This is the story of a selfish giant. He was very selfish. He always said, "My garden is my own garden, and I will allow nobody to enter here." He was very, very selfish, and he loves his garden so much. Every afternoon, as they were coming from school, the children used to go and play in the giant's garden. It was a large, lovely garden with soft green grass. Here and there, over the grass, stood beautiful flowers like stars, and there were 12 peach trees in the springtime broke out into delicate birds, sat on the tree and sang so sweetly that the children used to stop their games in order to listen to them. "How happy we are here," they cried to each other. One day, the giant came back. He had been to visit his friend and he had stayed with him for 7 years. When he arrived, he saw the children playing in the garden. "What are you doing here?" "Huh?" Then the children ran away. "My own garden is my own. Anyone can understand that. And I will allow nobody to play in it but myself." Now, he built a high wall all around it and put up a notice board. "He is a very selfish." Now, the children were left no place to play. They were considered playing on the road, but it was filled with dust and hard stones, which they did not like. So after the school, they would go and walk around the high walls that the giant had built. As they talk about the lovely garden inside them, they would remember how happy and delightful they were when they played in the garden. With the children away from the garden, the only two persons that seemed to be delightful, and they were the snow and the frost. They discussed among themselves how they will live in the garden for the entire year. Now that the spring had forgotten to arrive, the snow is told to have put her white cap all over the grass, while the frost colored all the trees in silver. Each of them even invited the north wind to stay with them. And now the winds came over with that high speed in the garden, making loud sound and removing chimney spots. The north. So the north wind thought it was a great spot for them to stay and invited the hail. Now the hail came with loud noise and it broke most the stales. Now it destroys the garden. He wore grey colored clothes and his breath was as cold as ice. He became very sad to see his garden. The selfish giant failed to understand the reason behind the delay in the arrival of spring. As he sat at the window and gazed at his cold white garden, he hoped for a change in the weather, but the spring never visited and nor did the summer. In other gardens, autumn granted golden fruits all over, but did not give any to the giant's garden because she felt he was too selfish. Thus the giant's garden, it was always cold and winter persisted. It was great news for the north wind, the hail, the frost and the snow, as all of them enjoyed and danced around the tree. One morning, the giant heard sweet and lovely music. It was a linnet singing outside his window. The hail and the north wind stopped, and he could feel the spring. He saw that the children came into his garden through a little hole. The children were sitting on the branches of trees, and the trees were blossoming. He also saw the birds flying and heard them chirping. The flowers had also come up. But to his surprise, in other corner, there was still winter. He saw that there a young boy was standing, and he was not able to reach the branches of the trees. The tree lowered its branches, but still he could not climb. मतलब कि उस ट्री ने अपनी ब्रांचेस को बहुत ज़्यादा लोअर्ड किया, फिर भी वो बच्चा उस ब्रांच को टच नहीं कर पा रहा था. At this scene, his heart melted. He realized that he was very selfish. He decided to put that boy on the top of the tree, pull down the walls and allow the children to play here forever. But when the children saw him, they ran away and the garden became winter again. However, the little boy did not run as he was weeping. The giant put him on the top of the tree and the tree blossomed at once. He kissed the giant. The other children realized that the giant is not wicked, came back. The spring came back with them. The giant used to play with the children ever afternoon, but that little boy was nowhere to be seen. As the year went by, he grew very weak. One winter morning, he saw a lovely tree with white blossoms in a corner. The branches of a tree were golden, and the little boy stood under it. The boy was wounded, which made the giant very angry. He told the boy he will not leave the man who harmed him. But the boy told him that no, this is the wound of the love. उसने बताया कि ये जो wounds हैं वो love के हैं, प्यार के हैं. The boy smiled and asked the giant to come to his garden. Later the children found the giant dead under the tree covered with white blossoms.